So Steve Spears.
Terry Rawlins.
Stella.
Stella.
Obviously you're not Stella.
No.
So,
I was Stella, it's gone a bit bad, isn't it? But it depends on your point of view.
I mean, it seems like Wales has rescued, I don't know, can we call it the British film, TV thing as of late?
It's not all at the moment, isn't it? Yeah.
It seems to be all happening in the valleys.
It is, yeah. And that's interesting, I thought about that. It does actually go to show that, you know, when people think they're in Wales, you're all on one bus, and you know, if you go back on that bus, you all know each other. It does make the feel of that a bit.
Because that's not true.
It is not true. Although I was with Rob Brydon the other day, and I know, and Ruth and I are friends, and Rob and I were old friends. He's very well.
Oh, there you go.
And then went out to LA, and there was Martin Sheen, and it's, I don't know. It just feels, I don't know what it is. I think it's our turn. Do you know what I mean? In fact, I've got to say that I think it's about time it was our turn, really, because for years I felt that, you know, the east of London was, well, even from the early films, like when whatever format it was, we won't mention Mary Poppins, but they were well represented. I think that the Irish have had a voice for a number of years in TV and film.
Well, has it been good to you?
Yeah, it has recently. Mm. It's been fantastic. I say recently as though, you know, I mean, I left Wales when I was 18. I've done quite a lot of work down there in the last 4 or 5 years, and I sort of feel in a way that I've been reclaimed a bit, you know, in some way. They've sort of gone, oh yeah, he's marshalling that guy, and they've brought me back a bit. Whereas, you know, sort of stuff
I was doing.
Yeah, I don't, well, I don't, then after
get you around him,
yeah, get him down there. I think that, you know, stuff that I've done, you know, building up to that, stuff that I was doing, like, I don't know, extras with Ricky Gervais or Sandra Junction, or the sort of independent films I did, as well as other ones. For about 10 years, I didn't do anything in Wales at all. I wasn't sort of, you know, looked at in that way, really, I think. And although I did do a Doctor Who, but that wasn't playing a Welsh guy or anything. And I think it's with Tidy Production and Ruth and that they've sort of, you know, sort of brought me back into it, really. And it's great, you know. Mm. It's a lot of mileage on the M4, but apart from that.
Yeah, well, you've even been out in space in Star Wars.
Yeah, I did Star Wars out in space. I was Captain Tarples.
Which not many people realise.
No, well, you wouldn't realise if you looked at it, actually, because it's basically, I don't know if you've seen it, just basically a bloke with a long neck and a head, and he's Jar Jar Binks' boss, and he has to say lines like, "You should be doo-doo, Jar Jar." And then Brian Blessed gets to go, "Ooh, Jar Jar," which didn't really go down well, considering we were talking to a black guy who was also in a thing with a big hat. So there was all sorts of problems at the time about it. And
there are science fiction nerds absolutely masturbating now.
They're going to love it all.
They're going to love it. What did you say?
You should be doo-doo, Jar Jar. What was the other line I had to say? I can't remember it. I had about 7 lines in it, actually.
When you was young, you never had a chat-up line.
No, I didn't. But you know, can I just say
now
that?
You have this. You can go to Comic-Con and absolutely just chat in.
Well, I've got to say this, right? I did go to one of these conventions, right?
I told you to.
Yeah, you did. You said you've got to go. There's a couple of quid out of
it. There is a couple of quid.
And I've got to say, this is a true story, right? I went to a Star Wars convention. If you are a Star Wars fan, I think you're the best fans in the world, right? And I went to this comic convention. If you're Stella fan, you're definitely. And anyway, I went to this comic convention, and there was a few of us on the stage, and there was.
They've gone now.
All right. Well, I tell you what, it was fantastic. It was myself. There was a guy who played Chewbacca called.
This
Peter.
Is Big Bang Theory.
Yeah. Right. Okay. They're really good. And of course, there was the most wonderful Kenny who played R2-D2. Who I should have traded with. I should have traded with R2-D2. And there's a guy called Mike Edmonds. Now Mike Edmonds was one of those little furry creatures that they call, let me know what they're called?
Ewoks.
And he also played Jabba the Hutt's tail, right? And the thing is, I went on this stage, he was in the tail movement, I went on this stage, it was my first convention, it was in Germany, I stood up on this stage, I dressed up in a suit, I thought I'm going to be really proper, and I'm going to, you know, grab it. Turned around, everybody just came in t-shirts and shorts and that. So I sat on the stage, and they're throwing it open for questions, and they've said, Mr. Spears, the first question, how did you get the job as Captain Tarples? And I went this long, really. So
went through the ranks.
Yeah, I went through the ranks. I did all about all I'd been seen at the National Bank. I did this and my voice, he wanted that, and he came, and I did the whole thing about he'd seen me on stage. I sounded like a right actor. And then they went, thank you very much.
Actor.
And then he goes, and now, and they gave the book down to little Mike and said, how did you get the job as Jabba's tail? And he turned around, he went, George said, can you fit in there? I felt a right tosser.